We're back with our hot-button topic, modernity affecting humanity. We're seeking solutions, and we're discussing our responsibilities as modernity injects itself into our lives. I was just speaking with Dr. Marwell, and he says there is no evidence of it. I'll beg to differ. I would say there's a great amount of evidence that child predators and internet predators have used modernity and technological advancements to hurt other people. That's why we have an internet crime unit in your country. Now, let me take that and talk to Dr. Zakaria.
Well, the example I gave was not to say that it should be taken as a blanket statement for the normal interaction with the internet. The reason I gave that statement was because it shows a lack of knowledge on it with regards to how you interact with a technology. Now, that technology or that game could have been on a PSP player. It didn't have to be on the internet. When we began the discussion, what I mentioned was it depends upon our interaction with modernity. And what we're talking about is just one aspect of modernity, that is technology which presents itself in an electronic format, i.e. the internet. But there are so many other aspects to modernity which we could discuss. For example, in vitro fertilization and the advancements in technology, heart transplantations, etc. But modernity depends how the individual interacts with it. It can be harnessed, i.e. the tools can be harnessed to bring great happiness and peace, whereas the tools can be harnessed to bring about suffering and pain, as we've seen within history. Those individuals who have nefarious designs, who don't have an understanding regarding human existence, that it should be cherished and enriched.
I like to go to my London audience and seek Newton's advice.
It's been affecting everyone, no? Because we've been tending to follow the path that we have to do in terms of working, going home, and sometimes it comes to quite stressful, and people they see modernity in a very stressful way. But if you get the right knowledge, it's just the way that you can create the right balance and do more positive things that you can address to all the fact of modernity.
I like to stay with my London audience.
From a political point of view, modernity has caused issues of terrorism. I think we picked up on this earlier, but it's caused issues of terrorism, which is breeding itself because modernity has allowed the possibility and the ability for the creation of nuclear weapons. And this has been a process that has been building on for 50 years. And from the point that the man from New York said about small groups and individuals being capable to do grave damage, which has already been seen in the past, modernity has clearly been seen to prove and to affect the safety of our modern day lives. Like, for example, if I was to walk in the park these days, I'd be a bit more cautious, and maybe I feel a lot more people are a bit more cautious about where their children are during school days because of the fear of, well, bombings. I know that's not the only reason, but I feel this modernity has brought a cautiousness to our society.
And that's an interesting point. I mean, I think a lot of these problems aren't exactly modern. I mean, a lot of these problems have existed for throughout time. I mean, as far as the danger element, I mean, I mean, people have been attacked throughout the ages by whatever rogues or thieves or whatever. What is true is that we're hearing more about it. So I'm not sure how much has really changed. It's just we're getting more information about it.
I like to see how our daily lives have been consumed with more distress, with human beings being in an uneasiness, in a discomfort as a result of everything that has been injected into our daily lives.
I think one thing that's very important is going off, is staying on the point of modernity, but it's changing the subject a little bit. I think that in my experience, certainly over my lifetime, I think things are a lot more fast-paced. And it's also to do with sitting down to enjoy meals. We eat a lot worse than we used to. I think young people growing up eat a lot of fast food, and I think this is to do with modernity, and I don't think that's been policed properly by government. I think that they could do more, we could do more to try and get people to eat right. We talk about terrorism, we've talked about internet, we've talked about all these other things. One of the biggest killers in our country and in America, even more so, is obesity, which I think become around by even using the internet, not doing enough sport, eating wrong, and not sitting down as a family. I think those are issues that we need to look at too.
Let's talk about that. Let's talk about obesity, and let's talk about the health implications of modern days. Certainly, it is a fast-paced life, and obesity is a byproduct of that, or isn't it? Let me talk to Washington D.C. and to my studio guests and see what you think, sir.
Obesity in America has become a national problem for our security, because 1 in 3 children are now obese. And from a dietitian's perspective, I think that modern medicine has done many great things as far as disease prevention and disease cures. However, the quality of life once we hit the age of 50 and beyond is downtrending, and I feel that a lot of foods and the disconnection between food and families are very apparent. And it's very apparent when we see that heart disease, cancer, diabetes, all influenced by obesity, are the core of our deaths in America. And these are diseases that are quite noticeably preventable, and they are preventable when we connect to our foods, eat with our families, and these foods are whole, natural, unprocessed foods consisting of typically plant-based diets. And we're finding that research is showing plant-based diets are causing mainstreams to flock towards these types of diets for disease prevention. If we can get back to that type of diet that we used to do back in the 1900s, we did not eat the amount of meat and dairy that we do today. And if we can continue to eat these high fibrous nutritional foods, we can get away from obesity and back to good health.